We are here tonight to discuss the Town and Village of Woodstock personnel policy. We've invited the employees to come and be present, and we'd like your input. We'd like you to be polite and courteous, and we ask that you, when you speak, as we have one trustee and one board member on the phone, that you speak clearly and state your name. So we'll open the meeting without any further ado.
Yeah.
So who would like to speak? We're in the process right now of making more these copies. That's where Nikki is, to make some more copies of the personnel policy. And Joe, you raised your hand.
Yes, I did. Would you want me to wait for...
Yeah, I mean, she should be taking notes.
Let's wait for Nikki. So that's what you have to say is recording.
We are recording. Yes, we are.
Oh, we are recording.
We are recording.
Sure.
And we'll take a slight delay, waiting for the scribe to return. Yeah, it's working.
Is it recording?
The red light is on at the top of the...
Yeah.
The red light is on.
We're recording. I told you so.
Oh, you asked.
All right.
Thank you to the trustees and select board for hearing us. And this is Joe Swanson, and talking directly on the phone to Jill Davies and Carrie Cole. I would just like to say that, you know, 1 to 2 years ago, we had a meeting similar to this. We were told in no uncertain terms by the town manager that changes were for future employees, that current employees' benefits packages were considered to stay the same. I don't think these changes by these board members are done in good faith. That being said, moving forward, these changes and making changes is setting the new town manager up for failure. Seems that the new town manager will be walking into a beehive that has been agitated and will cause dissent and distrust among current employees that don't feel trusted and valued. We can't continue to do our jobs if we lose our workforce among our different departments, and we can't provide the services necessary if we lose our quality workforce that we have here today. So I think it's important to pump the brakes on this, to stop before we make any rash decisions, to let our new town manager get settled and give him the opportunity of success. Thank you.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, Joe.
I'm sorry, Butch.
Joe, is there any particular change that you're referring to that you don't like or that you do like?
I think changes forced upon us is a situation that's going to create conflict between the boards and employee and the future town manager, the boards and employees. And I think it's important to give the new town manager the opportunity for success. I think it's important to have employees to give us a stable workplace, and for the board to consider input from employees and the new town manager all in a joint work group if there are going to be changes in the future.
So there isn't a particular change that you're speaking to?
I am not speaking to particular changes. I'm sure that there are numerous questions from the rest of, from everyone else. I'm just speaking in terms of the overall effect that this will have. Thank you.
Anybody else in the back?
Hi, Jessica Ryan LeBlanc. As most of you know, I'm a Woodstock police officer. I'm also an EMT. One of the changes that, to me, has the biggest effect on us all is the inability to accrue further sick time. And the concern for me is twofold. One, had I not been able to bank sick time over the last couple of years, when my back went out, and then I later sprained my ankle upon being released to full duty, and now I've got the cold virus, I would not have had the sick time to take to make sure that I'm taking care of myself so that I can give the citizens of Woodstock the care that they're accustomed to receiving. The other concern that I have in taking away that accrual of sick time is it's one of the benefits that our chief and the town has been able to take to prospective employees and say, you know, we offer you this really great benefit package, and part of that is the ability to continually accrue sick time should God forbid you ever need it. I think when we're competing with larger agencies that are able to offer more money and more benefits just based on their size, that this is one of the things that makes us a competitive department besides working for the beautiful village and such a really great chief.
Yes, Mary.
I want to specifically note that this policy change, it did not come from any board member of either the select board or the trustees. It was something that was brought up at town meeting by a citizen of Woodstock speaking on behalf of a group of concerned citizens. And this has been written in response to that concern. And that is how it has been moved forward. And as you all know, the people who wrote this policy have spent a lot of time on it. They have done comparison studies of other towns and villages and cities in Vermont, and they have presented what they feel is a fair proposal. It is nothing that is adopted yet, and it's still under consideration, but this was the issue that was raised most strongly at a meeting, and it was the sick time accrual of sick time over a long period of time. And that is why the committee working on the policy has specifically addressed what you see written there today.
Is it possible that
Frank, can you address the addition of the short-term disability policy, please? And how that would affect us then?
Well, are you finished? You got more to say?
The one thing I would suggest is that maybe there's the possibility of going forward, putting a cap to new employees' sick time accrual. So maybe saying, okay, we give you the 12 days, 96 hours a year to accrue, and you can accrue up to, I don't know what a fair or reasonable amount of time off would be, but maybe there's some kind of bargaining that could be done there.
You know that there's a short-term disability situation which every employee qualifies for after 8 days. And if it's an accident that happens, That begins at day one. And short-term disability will give you 2/3 of your salary until such time as an employee, and we hope this would never happen, would become eligible for long-term disability, which would cover you without lapse until you reached retirement age. That's nothing we're anticipating or hoping or anything like that would ever happen to any of you. But it is, it's an insurance that is there to assure you would have income until you reached retirement age.
Do you still have a question of Frank? Or did Mary answer it?
No, I think we got some new information. So
all right.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I have one more. Zoe has a question. Zoe, before you, Mark.
I'm sorry, I just have a response to the short-term disability. And Frank, correct me if I'm wrong, but we went over this today. During your, if you are to receive short-term disability, that check does not come from the town. It then comes from the company that we're using for short-term disability, which means that your benefits that you receive from the town are no longer being paid by the town. Those would then be out of pocket. So just want you to understand that we do not pay health care. The town does not pay your health care during those situations. Am I right? Did we clarify that? Your IMED, your retirement is not taken out of that. So that's just one thing to consider, that once your sick time is not being used, you don't have the benefits that the town now provides for you.
Thank you.
And nor would you have them after you exhausted whatever sick time you had.
Which is true. Yeah, but just to clarify that.
Dunker is next.
I just have Mark Donka, Police Department. A question about the sick time for somebody like an old guy like me. somebody who's been here for 6 years, I've accrued a lot of sick time. I haven't used much. I've got over, I think, 500 hours on it. So it's saying here that I get to keep that. So say I get sick now. I call down and hurt my leg or whatever at home. I use up my 12 days. Do I go right on to the short-term disability, or do I have to use up my 500 hours that I've accrued by being a good employee?
You do not have to use all of your banked sick time. When the sick time is banked, there will be a fund, a balance, that you and the town or village, in your case, will agree that you have banked. And it does not seem that that's going to happen. But if it came to the point where you had exhausted any other source of income and needed to get that, there will be something in place that will be adopted by the board and the individual. We're working on that.
But there's nothing in here.
There is nothing in there right now about that. But it is something that will have to be signed by both parties, that you understand how and why you would access that if it was to come to that. Because once that's gone, if you were to reach retirement age, you would not have what was the initial
amount. You would have the bank amount.
Number one. Secondly, this is a piece of this concern that we have, that it is for those employees who leave with a 2-week notice. It is for those employees who might retire with a substantial notice of when you're going to leave your job. Now, if we pay that money to you before those things happen, or in the case that someone is terminated, which again, we hope would not happen, if that money's already gone, there'll be nothing for, there would be nothing for the retirement employee, there would be nothing for someone who would leave under good condition. And if we paid out $10,000 or $15,000 to someone who then comes in and gets terminated in a couple of weeks, there is no recourse for the town or village in that matter. And those are the things we're considering in adopting how the individual can access that money. And I think you would understand
that. Well, I understand that part. Like I said, that there's nothing in there saying.
Not yet.
It just says it's going to be on the books.
Not yet.
And it's going to be there, right?
Well, this is still, this is draft number 10.
Okay.
So we still have a little ways.
Are you asking to use the sick time in lieu of short-term disability if you have accrued sick time?
No, the opposite.
No, the opposite.
No,
I'm saying,
doesn't
I have to exhaust
okay.
the accrued
I just want, before I just want I to be sure.
No, and you will not have to use your sick time.
When Officer LeBlanc was talking about the, you know, people comparing other unions and stuff or other departments and things around the area, Hartford Police basically let you accrue as much sick time as you want, but you don't get it when you leave. But what they do do, which I think everybody would be, is they provide health insurance until you go on Medicare. So whatever you're paying when you retire from Hartford, they take your sick time, but if say you're paying whatever the amount is per week, you would stay at that same amount and you would keep your health care. And the town would, of course, have to pick up.
May I ask you a question,
sure.
Mark? Do you know what percentage of their health care benefit they would pay, that they pay currently in Hartford?
I don't know exactly what they pay, but I know that it was, the way it was drawn up was whatever you were paying at the time would continue.
Well, there was so a percentage or something.
Well, it changed. I don't know what it was, because I know one guy that went out when they were paying 100%, he purposely went out, they paid 100% for the next 10 years for him.
Purposely went out?
Not on retirement. He retired.
I see.
Upon retirement.
Well, back around 2014, is that when Obamacare or the American...
The Affordable Care Act.
Affordable Care, thank you. Mm-hmm. When that went into effect, there was... COBRA was much more extensive than it is now, and it included a possibility for retirees to continue to pay. And the select board and the trustees at that time reviewed the policy going forward. And it was decided for health care benefits, they would no longer allow that. And I was one of the employees that was consulted at that time because I was within a few years of retirement and they knew that. I understood completely why they did it, because the assessment overall for employees would have involved the town. And so for that reason, that was discontinued a few years ago.
Okay.
But any employee who leaves the employ at this point is able to pay the dental at the amount it is, or the vision at the amount it is, and there are substantial increases every couple of years. And for me, that has amounted to a $10 increase per month, and I've been retired 5 years.
Okay. All right, and just to piggyback on what Sergeant Swanson said about retaining people and keeping people, right now, I mean, it took us, 8 months to hire somebody, or eight months or almost a year to hire someone. Right now, there's 35 police departments actively advertising in Vermont for officers. So you have a lot of competition out there, and if you do change benefits around stuff, you know, Woodstock isn't the highest paid in this area. You know, you can go down the road to Hartford and make $5 more an hour walking in the door. So it's something that I'm, like I said, on the downhill slide. I'm looking at retirement in, you know, another 20 or 30 years. But
don't do it too soon.
It's something to, you know, look at. If you're going to try to get people and get quality people here, you do have to keep up a little bit with the Joneses as far as pay and as far as benefits, where they're going to look elsewhere.
We understand that, and those That consideration is one of the reasons, and I'm sure you've all read, that we've moved the vacation accrual time back a little. You now get 3 weeks a little earlier than one you, than you once did, and more, and so on. And those were taken into consideration at the time that we did that.
Right.
And the contribution for employee benefits or health insurance is not changing. Mm-hmm. All of that was considered when they wrote this policy.
Okay.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, Mark. Thanks, Mark. Anybody else? Joe?
Oh, Mary, yes, my question.
Okay. Anybody else?
One thing, if we're speaking about the benefit of being able to...
This is Zoe speaking.
Sorry, thank you. If we're thinking about what we're adding, keeping in this, one thing I would like there to be some consideration for is if we are able to keep the benefits at whatever the rate the town is paying, even if the person is to retire, to leave, whatever that looks like, if the premium could be paid by that employee for a period of time. It's not COBRA, but if we would be able to, like it is now, you didn't mention health care, but perhaps health care could be part of that package as well.
We could certainly look into that.
Is that legal?
It is. Well, it was through Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
They could just come in and write a check, even though they're not working for the employer anymore.
How are we doing that with iMed? How are we doing that with Delta?
We only iMed and Delta Dental. The health benefit isn't available that way at this time. That was voted out a few years ago.
I think we should look into that, only because our circumstance that happened in July provided information to me that that was different.
Yeah.
Okay. So again, it's just a research sort of a thing. I'm not saying it might be a nice benefit to somebody,
that
even if it's within a period of time. I'm not saying lifers should hop on board, but as we look at reductions in a few places, looking at maybe some other areas that maybe we could increase for the employees as
Let
well.
Let me mention this to you. In that consideration, would you expect that the employee would then pay 100% of
yes.
their
yes.
benefit
yes.
and not have a percentage such as you
No,
have
because
now.
They would no longer be an employee.
Okay.
It would
Thank
be
you.
A yeah, full premium.
Thank you.
That's a good consideration. Thank you. Ken?
Yes. Ken Vandenberg, Highway Department. I'm the Highway Superintendent. I have seven staff. There's eight of us. This whole rewrite policy thing has been quite an uproar in my department. I want to thank all of you for taking the time to listen to us, because that's really all we can ask for. What has happened when employees first heard of a possible rewrite to the policy, employees asked right up front to be involved with the committee. That didn't happen for whatever reason. What that did was create distrust between the employees and the board. What are they doing? Why are they doing this? They didn't understand. I've had to take a lot of time and try to explain things to these guys of what's going on. I understand the accrued sick time to be an antiquated policy. I understand it to have a liability. I've been on boards, I understand the numbers. But every employee in this town was told, you have this benefit if you come to work for us. Now it's being taken. It's how it's viewed by everyone I have spoke with. In that, I sat with them, and believe me, there were some heated discussions. And I said, we can go to the board and try to fight this, but we're all convinced this policy is inevitable. You're not going to grandfather the existing employees. So what can we do so that both sides leave with no animosity? And basically, by going to the short-term disability, the long-term disability, we're not made whole by this change of policy. We will now, instead of using accrued sick time to And when we use that, our retirement, our health insurance was covered by the town via that. Now, we don't know, do we come right to town to check if we're out for any amount of time? Because short-term and long-term do not cover those costs. So we thought, well, maybe we can ask for some considerations. One of the considerations would be to cover those costs while we, or if we are out. The copay on the health insurance that the town typically covers. That could have pretty significant financial impact on a lot of my employees. So we would ask for that consideration to at least make us whole in that aspect. Possibly some other sort of consideration so that we at least feel the policy changed and that we didn't get beat up and feel like the boards are trying to finance the budget on the backs of the employees are some of the terms I've heard. Personally, I think it would be fair to do some sort of consideration to the employees for what they will be losing with this policy that's written. Thank you.
I want you all to understand that every member of both boards agree that you are one of our, if not the biggest asset that we have. And we would really not want to lose any one of you over this. It is not formally adopted. There is room to change. Your suggestions are worthy of consideration. I've written them down. Everyone's heard them. Nikki has them on the record. And just ask that you be patient with us for a little longer. We're going to meet again on Thursday morning, and we will discuss things at that time. And I would also take any other information you'd like to give us tonight. But I do have a question about what you just mentioned, Ken, and it was to do with the percentage of health insurance you said. A copay, you mean the amount that the employee pays
exactly.
Cover that along right with paying the medical insurance while you're out?
Yes, what would happen right now if I fell tomorrow and broke my leg? We don't have short-term disability, so I would fall back on my accrued sick time. Because my paycheck comes from the town, they take my retirement, the health care costs, all of that out of my check. Mm-hmm. In the scenario proposed under this policy, I'm now getting a check from insurance company X, who aren't going to cover those costs. They're not going to be deducted. So who pays that? Obviously, they've said what the town does it. But I think in fairness, it would be a good consideration to do that. Even if not, if the retirement went on hold, what I'm trying to say is I'd like my staff to be able to not have to pay for medical insurance on top of being out on two-thirds pay.
That's...
Why doesn't disability pay for health insurance?
Part of the policy.
I don't think you would find...
Because it's a benefit. It's a benefit that the town gives, not that Lincoln Financial or Reliance gives.
This is a disability company. And I don't think you would find one that did. Now,
Well, I'd like to echo what Mary said, that I've been here a long time, and I realize that everybody who works for the town and village is our valued employees, and this is not in any intent to squeeze out anybody from anything that would make it desirable for them to leave or go somewhere else. We are in some tight budget restrictions, and as Mary said, this was brought up last year at town meeting on the floor, and I feel we were obligated to look into it. We established a couple of people, one from the village and one from the town, to look into it, and this is the results of it, and we're listening to you. And any suggestions that you have that's going to fit within the scope of the purpose, we'll take into consideration. I think I speak for both the town and the village in that.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
Go ahead, Beth.
Beth Vish, can I just suggest, instead of like a set time and no accrual, that you allow accrual to a certain point, but then say the stipulation that it's not paid, so stop the payout at the end for retirement, but allow people to accrue their sick time so that if they should need it, I mean, I was just out for 4 days with the flu and a bunch of other stuff, and I can tell you right now, I have no sick time left. But I would have had even less because it's February with those 12 days. It's one of those things, if you get hit multiple times in a year with an illness or an injury and you need to rely on that sick time, but you only have 12 days, but then the next year you're not sick at all, you should be able to accrue the sick time to use it when you need it. I think it'd be fair to say, hey, we're no longer gonna pay out. The state of Vermont does not pay out for sick. They do not pay out at the end. They pay out for your vacation, but they do not pay out for your sick. And I think we should be able to accrue sick time, but maybe it just doesn't pay out at the end.
Thank you.
Good consideration. Ladies first, Joe.
Okay. So a couple things as I've looked at the policy, and just so you know, I'm our HR person. I do our benefits. So first of all, I was floored when there was any changes and that the policy was given, the changes were given to other people, but they weren't given to me. I had two people come to me and say, so what do you think of the changes? And I felt like an idiot because I knew nothing about it. So I let the record stand for that. But also, as I've been speaking to people and as they've come to me and we've had these conversations, some things that I've looked at with other towns, with the state of Vermont, are possibly a payout of some of the sick time, but in a much smaller portion, as opposed, instead of losing your sick time at the end of the year, maybe there's a payout of 1 week. We don't pay out all of it, but okay, I have a lot of sick time. I don't use a lot of my sick time. So maybe I don't get the 2 weeks that I accrued, but maybe I would lose a week, you would pay out a week. Just a suggestion, something to think about. Another thing that's not in this policy, and again, another consideration, we're trying to accommodate a lot of people and make people feel like the employees are being considered, is something to do with wellness. That's not in there. We have a lot of opportunity in this town. We have a racket club, the athletic center, we have the rec center, we've got hiking, we've got golf, we've got all these things that are here. And okay, so maybe there is something that comes into play that is a slight benefit to the employees, whether it's, you know, we pay, Woodstock Inn gives us a 10% discount on that. We don't even give our employees any sort of a stipend, an allowance or anything for wellness, which...
The police force gets a stipend for wellness,
we
right?
We have a fitness stipend if we're able to stay in shape with it.
Right.
Let me tell you,
but I mean, that should come along with it, but right. But I was just making sure I was correct on it.
Yes, but that's not something that's given to anybody else. And with premiums going up, with, as you know, with Blue Cross and Blue Shield, having to change, I just think that would be a really good incentive somehow, if there could be a maximum amount that was paid toward that somehow. I don't know what that looks like, but since we have an open forum, I just wanted to bring that to the floor.
Good idea.
For all the employees.
Good suggestions.
That is something that I have thought about, but have not even mentioned because of what I see on the other end of that. A lot of people could take advantage of that, but with scheduling and family commitments and other things that have to happen. I watched one time when that was offered, and the employer signed, the people signed up and the employer paid. And the only ones that were getting anything from that was the organization where they were paying because the people weren't going.
May I just add to, I know for us in the, in town hall here, we have an hour lunch break. There was some talk about keep it, not keep it, but that would be a way that we could utilize that time to step out. It would, again, not feel like we were taking from our home time or our busy life. It would be a mental break. It would be a physical break. It would, I think, be a good way for us to feel like we were able to use that. The town wouldn't feel like they were paying for something that wasn't being used. Just a suggestion.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody else like to speak on behalf of the employees or? Joe?
Oh, yeah, I just had, Joe Swanson, I just had two follow-up thoughts. Listening to what Ken was saying, I agree with him. And one thing that I hadn't thought of because I didn't know the 60%. If we're docked 60, our current sick time, we can take at full rate, our benefits are fully paid. We're not out of pocket, we're not going underwater. If we, the time we use, we're then able to rebuild with our future employment. So that if we get sick again or injured again, we're not starting from scratch. That, on top of that, you know, if we're getting, if we're at 60%, and then we have to start paying, we're really at 50% of what we're making, and that's not enough to live on.
Thank you for mentioning that, Joe.
And talking about what Beth was saying, I think we'd like to keep our sick time that we've earned at pay, the payout rate that we have earned. Don't want to give that up.
Okay, thank you.
Waylon Lord, Wastewater Department. You mentioned the changes in the vacation parameters and stuff, and each parameter has an addition to it with less years except the older group, which has no addition to it whatsoever. In other words, if you first two intervals, you gain 3 weeks over the period difference in the new time and the old time.
Right.
Later on, you gain 2 weeks in the third and fourth parameter. But you still, in the fifth parameter, people that's been here 25 years or more, you don't increase it at all. I don't think that's fair across the board.
But that means you already have all your benefits for the full amount. You wouldn't need more. You're already getting the full level. Is that correct?
That's correct.
And how many weeks? You're only allowed a certain amount of weeks per year. You're not going to get more. It's just the other people get to that full amount sooner.
Correct.
Wayland.
And that adds up to a total of 10 weeks over the parameter of building up to 25 years.
What at 25 years? What is the vacation
30,
time?
30 work days.
30 work days. So that's 6 weeks vacation. I don't know this, and I will check with a couple of surveys that I know are available and information that's available, and Jill and Serena probably has, is that I don't know where you'll find employment where there's any more than 6 weeks vacation.
No.
Ken's agreeing with me. I think 6 weeks vacation for someone who would start working at a young age, and we have some here who have, will reach that 26 years if they stay with us at a young age, and they won't be close to retirement age by the time they're at that 6 weeks. And I really think that's very generous, and I think it's a lot more than you'll find in many places. In a lot of situations in municipalities, I think they stop in a month, which is 4 weeks, right. 4 to 5. Zoe.
Yes, sorry to keep standing up. Can you tell me what Bill Kerbin's comments were to this policy? Because we did ask that he would.
I've not spoken to Bill, I have not communicated with him. I don't know if Frank has any information about that.
He indicated that he thought the process was well underway and he really didn't want to weigh in from a distance.
So given that, again, I would just ask this, if we could not make or adopt any of this, I really feel strongly that the new municipal manager ought to have time to weigh in, to look, to add, to make some suggestions. Given that he is from a different area, he has different experience, he may come in with some really good ideas as well. And if we're worried or concerned about going to town meeting and having someone say, gee, have you done something about this? The answer can simply be, yes, we are working on it.
Yes, Zoe, we have talked about that, and while we aspire to adopt this policy very soon, because it's been a long time, we can stand at town meeting and say exactly what you're proposing we say. However, when we met with the League of Cities and Towns back in October, it was stressed to us that policies are established by the boards and the municipal manager works with the policy that we have established. And that's where we are. It's not adopted. I won't be surprised if Bill is here before it really happens.
Elijah's been...
Oh, I can see Elijah. Oh.
Oh, sorry.
I know what you're talking about.
Elijah from the wastewater department.
Yes.
First, I'd like to say thank you for putting in that you're looking to adopt a 457 plan. I'm glad that that's going to be included. And I'd like the board to consider some type of small employer match to encourage employee participation, because it can be a powerful personal savings tool, a tax-deferred account. And if there's some type of an employer match, it would encourage employee participation. And whether it's one idea to kind of echo a little bit what Zoe said is maybe if there is some consideration of giving any type of a payout for the sick time, maybe offering it as a rollover into this account for an employer match, or maybe a small percentage, but something like that. I'd appreciate if the board would consider something like that. There's one other thing, the cash in lieu policy for the health insurance. The way it is rewritten, there's a bit of ambiguity in it versus the original, as far as how it's paid out, as far as there's just some ambiguity, and I'd like the board to look at that wording and clarify that. I've mentioned it to Frank already.
And the board is.
So, can you tell us exactly what page you're on, Elijah?
For
the article number?
It is. I can tell you how the wording has changed roughly. I can paraphrase it. In the past, it said that.
I just want to make sure that I go to exactly the right place.
Okay. All right. So that's page 12 of 23. And it is in the paragraph above the eligibility requirements.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
In the back, Joe.
I'd just like to follow up a little bit on what Zoe has said a moment ago. Yes, it's the boards do establish policy, and the town manager manages the town based on that policy. But given that we have an opportunity here that doesn't come along very often, where a new town manager is coming in with different experiences, different education, different feelings about things, his suggestions might be worth listening to. Not that he's going to make the policy, but that he may have some valuable input that may help the process smooth out a little bit.
It could also go the other way.
It could.
Just saying.
Absolutely, yes.
I don't mean to bring it up that way, but he might be like, you guys should have done this 30 years ago.
Yeah.
Probably should have.
What are we going to do with that?
Probably should have.
Okay. I don't mean to make it sound like that, and we appreciate all of you guys.
I think we're here to listen today, and I think we've heard a lot of good...
And we're going back to the drawing board.
A lot of good notes, and we're going back to the drawing boards, and Michael Brands is back there, and he would like to speak, and he'd like to come up so that the people on the phone can hear you.
I'm sure she can hear me from where I stand.
There are two people here, Michael.
Can you hear?
Two people.
Carrie and Carrie Cole and Jill are on the phone.
I want to echo Joe and Ken and some of the other remarks that were made here, that the employees were not involved in this process. I believe I've heard this was brought up at last town meeting, this request. Is that correct?
Well, it's suggested from
the floor
that we looked into it.
Right, and so I don't know when that process started, but apparently it started fairly late in the year. And right now you're trying to rush something through so that you can have something for the next town meeting, is my understanding of this process. And I'd like to echo Joe and other people here that we should wait until the new town manager comes and see what they have for input.
Michael, if I could interrupt you
Please.
Just a little bit. I don't think there's any intent of this board to rush, or either this either boards to rush anything through.
Well, I see a March 1st deadline here that we all have to sign contract, and our hours are set in stone at that point. So when I see a March 1st deadline, I assume this wants to be done immediately.
Well, February 29th being town meeting, Michael, which is just 11 days away, I don't believe it is even possible to do it. Because as time has gone on, and we have all these suggestions, there's a lot to consider.
And why were not the employees involved, especially after Joe's statement that we were told we would be involved in any personnel changes?
I can't
And that echoes,
that.
If I may, on the contract which is proposed here. If I may read that page here. D of Addendum A, Acknowledgement of Personnel Policies. I acknowledge that these personnel policies replaces any and all prior versions, and that the town or village reserves the right to add, amend, or discontinue any of the provisions of these personnel policies for any reason or none at all, in whole or in part at any time, with or without notice. That does not allow any room for employee involvement. And that's a difficult issue talking over with many of the employees here, that
I
you have to sign this, otherwise...
I believe some of that is advice of legal counsel, why some of these things were added.
But it doesn't get back to the original question, why weren't the employees involved in this process?
I was not on the committee, and I'm sorry, I can't answer that.
We were promised that the last go-around a couple years ago. My main input here...
So you are being consulted. You are being consulted right now. I think what we should do is take the data March the 1st off the table and say that this is consulting you.
Okay, Michael still has the floor, if we could, please.
Okay, my main input here is for future employees. Woodstock's been a wonderful place to live. We can't afford to offer the salaries that a lot of other communities can offer. We know this is a very high rent district. It's very difficult to purchase a property here. The benefits are the only thing that are hanging these employees, that are making people want to work here. I have a number of, I have only four people applying for my position. I'm very worried, due to some of the employee process, the benefit packages here, that we may lose some of those if we're carrying on the way we do. So I'm just asking that you listen to the employees and that we pay attention to the future of this community. It's been a very wonderful place to work, and we all love it here, and we want to continue that. And we want to have good employees, and we don't want to have a blue flu in June, which is very likely, where people are going to accumulate their vacation, because no one's going to take sick time until they use it. If we have to use it, they're all going to come in June, the last 2 weeks of June, you won't see anybody working because they have to take their sick time. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you, Michael.
Next was, I have, Joe was next, are you?
Yeah.
Joe Swanson?
Joe Swanson, replying directly to Jill Davies here.
Can you hear Jill?
This is not how we feel involved. Your statement that this is involving us is not resonating with us. Involving us would have been from the beginning.
Yes.
Thank you.
And I note that there are other employees in the room nodding their heads in agreement with what Joe's recent statement.
And Beth, you had your hand up next?
He just said it.
And you were next?
Yes. I have actually a couple of questions. Ken Vandenberg again. Reading through the policy in whole, there were a couple places, and I do have them, get my glasses out. Just clarifications, they're vague statements. I didn't know if they'd be clarified better. Article 7, Conflict Resolution and Grievance, page 5, step number 2. The clarification in sentence number 2 of within a reasonable period, that's extremely vague. Is a reasonable period the next board meeting, two board meetings? And step 3 of the same article, sentence 4, the last sentence, take place as soon as practical. Both are just very vague. I didn't know if in continuing you'd clarify that a little at the next, within two board meetings, or some time parameters so that somebody would have a better understanding.
Thank you.
We will take that up when we meet again. Thank you for pointing that out, Ken.
Anybody else?
Tim.
Tim Lyons, Wastewater. Just a question that I probably should have asked earlier. A year ago, I took care of my mother for 3 months. I used my sick time. I banked it. In February, I found out in 2019 I had kidney cancer. I had to take care of in June. I burned my time up, and I thank you guys for letting me cure that. I have 39 hours. Okay? I've been here 14 years. You're giving a short-term disability. That's great. What happens if my mother got sick after we adopt this policy? That short-term disability is not going to cover that, is it?
No, it is not. Okay.
So I would have been out roughly, I think I used 250 hours with my mother because she ended up with Alzheimer's. The last week of her life, I spent maybe working a day here, day there. Phil was very forgiving for me and let me go to be with her in hospital. What happens to some of the younger employees here who still have their parents? We're all aging. What happens to that benefit? Because believe me, it was huge to me that I got to spend that time with my mother. Thank you.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you. Anybody else? All right, if not, we will.
Can I just say one more thing, please?
Yes, please.
Yes, Jeff.
Okay. I do want to say that this is the second time that we've consulted employees, in that the first time was consulting the department heads, where we have made several changes based on their comments, and so this is now coming up with a proposal that is coming to all employees.
Thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
One more in the back, and then we have to close.
It's Jess Ryan LeBlanc again.
Can you hear it from back there?
Can you hear Jessica?
Go ahead, Jessica.
Jess.
Hi. One of the things, the blue flu is a very real thing, and working for a police department that requires 24/7 coverage, it's in a way terrifying to the employees who will be stuck trying to make up that coverage come May or June when people do have a lump of sick leave still left. I don't actually enjoy working 60 to 70 hours a week and trying to do everything else that life requires. I'm lucky enough that I have a partner who will grocery shop and take care of the animals when I do work that many hours. So, you know, the idea of someone taking those hours, or multiple people taking hours that they would otherwise lose, isn't very comforting. I have just one more thing quickly that I don't think can really maybe be resolved, but it's a paragraph that makes me feel particularly nervous. Article 5, under employee discipline, the last paragraph before section 1, the town and village also retain the right to unilaterally eliminate positions or reduce the work hours of a position or positions due to economic conditions, shortage of work, organizational efficiency, changes in departmental functions, and or reorganization or reclassification of positions resulting in the elimination of a position, or for other related reasons. I get that Vermont is a hire at will state, which is nerve-wracking to employees on its own. But what I read in that paragraph is, if we decide we don't want you here, you won't be here anymore.
Thank you. Okay, with that being said, Jeffrey, do you have any comments?
The only comment I have is to thank all of you, not only for being here today, but for the work you do for this village and town. And it is appreciated, and we are taking your comments today very seriously.
Very seriously. I would echo that. Thank you all for coming, and that being said, I would entertain a motion to close this portion of the meeting.
I move we close this portion of our meeting.
Motion's been made and seconded that we close this portion of the meeting.
And Anna's making that motion for the trustees. Seconded by Carrie. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Thank
Thanks,
you.
Everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.